Kiwi Syslog Server is an affordable log management tool for IT admins. It lets you collect, filter, alert, forward, and store log messages. Kiwi Syslog Server listens to syslog messages and SNMP traps from network devices such as routers, switches, and firewalls, and Linux and Unix servers. You can also enable Kiwi Syslog Server to receive Windows event logs in syslog format for further log management actions such as filtering and alerting. Kiwi Syslog Server can be installed as an application or Windows service. Most users choose to install as a service. This allows Kiwi Syslog to continue processing messages even when the program window is closed or the user is not logged in. The desktop console allows you to monitor syslog messages in real time. Kiwi Syslog Server listens for messages on UDP port 514, as this is the default port designated for devices sending syslog messages as defined in the RFC standard 5426. Kiwi Syslog can be configured to listen to any other UDP port, and can also listen for syslog messages over TCP as well as SNMP traps. If sources are sending messages on the same port specified in Kiwi Syslog Server, messages will automatically appear in the console. Kiwi Syslog Server processes syslog messages through a set of customizable rules based on a combination of filters and actions that you specify. Filter allows you to refine incoming messages by priority, IP address, host name, message text, time of day, and input source. Action allows you to execute from a set of built-in actions which include display log messages on the console, logging to a file or database, forwarding messages to another host, running an external program, sending email messages, syslog messages, or SNMP traps, running a script, or logging to Kiwi Web Access. Upon the initial launch of Kiwi Syslog Server, there is a default rule that contains no filter, but has two pre-configured actions, display and log to file. Since no filter is set, all incoming messages will be displayed on the monitoring console, as well as logged to a text file. The log to file action in this default rule is configured to automatically create a daily file with the current date appended to the file name. By default, these files will be saved indefinitely. Later in the video, we'll show you how to create a custom retention schedule. You can add new filters, modify these actions, or build new rules as desired. Kiwi Syslog Server provides 25 virtual displays which can be renamed for convenience to monitor messages based on custom filter conditions. Kiwi Syslog Server also allows for custom DNS resolution to display the device's hostname in lieu of the source IP address. Let's create a new rule to filter the display messages with the string logoff in the message text. To begin, click on File, Setup. Right-click on Rules and select Add Rule. Rename it to Logoff Messages. Right-click on Filters and choose Add Filter. Rename it to Filter Logoff. Select Message Text from the field menu, leaving the filter type as simple. Enter logoff in quotes in the include field. Now let's create a second filter. Rename it to warning priority. Then select priority from the field menu. Click on the warn column to highlight. Finally, click on the green check to select. Right-click on actions and choose add action. Rename the action to display. Select display from the action menu. Then select display 01 from the display number menu. Add a second action. Rename it as email. Select Email Message from the Action menu. Enter the email recipient, sender, subject, and message content. Now click OK. This rule will execute the filters and actions in a sequential order. Once the filter conditions are met, the messages will first be displayed on the screen and then sent as an email message. The Log Monitoring Console also provides the option to view syslog statistics in intuitive charts. Triggering alerts when certain syslog messages are received is one of the most popular features in Kiwi Syslog Server. The advanced filter conditions allow you to set flags, counters, and thresholds to trigger alerts. You can specify the number of times a filter condition is met in a given time interval. If, for example, a certain number of login failures occur within 10 minutes, or if a filter condition is not met in a given time frame, such as a scheduled task not completing. Alerting is most commonly done via email. You can customize the email fields including sender ID, recipient ID, email subject, and body content. There are a variety of options to enter variables in the email body that can automatically populate the time, date, message content, IP address, and/or host name based on the message received. Kiwi Syslog Server comes with a built-in web access utility allowing you to view, monitor, and modify filter settings remotely from any web browser. By simply clicking on any message field, Kiwi Syslog Server will populate all related messages. Let's select the facility of cron, and the level of critical, and the message text of failed. You can remove any of these by clicking on their respective X. You can also save this filter for future use. In addition, filters can be created from scratch on the Filters tab. Simply click Add Filter Item, choose the filter field, predicate, and field operator, as well as the filter expression. There are also options for highlighting messages, adjusting message rows per page, and user management. Log Forwarder for Windows is a free, optional agent that lets you monitor Windows event logs. This tool converts Windows event logs into syslog format and forwards them to Kiwi Syslog Server. In the Log Forwarder console on the Windows host, you can select the event types you wish to forward to Kiwi Syslog Server and define the default syslog facility for these events. Go to Syslog Servers and specify the IP address and port number of the Kiwi Syslog Server or servers. These events will then appear on your Kiwi Syslog Server and be processed through your set of rules. The Log Forwarder agent can be deployed on any number of Windows servers or workstations as required. Kiwi Syslog Server can perform log retention, archival, and cleanup actions to help enterprises and federal agencies meet compliance requirements such as PCI DSS, HIPAA, SOX, and other regulatory standards. The Schedules engine in Kiwi Syslog Server can be used to compress and archive logs, as well as delete logs based on their date or size. Let's run through the creation of a new archive and cleanup schedule. Let's say you would like to archive your log files every 3 months and delete files older than 1 year. First, you must create an archiving schedule. Go to File, then Setup. Right-click on Schedules and choose Add New Schedule. Rename the schedule to Archive. On the Schedule tab, move the slider to Day. On the Source tab, populate the source location with the path containing your log files. Under File Age, click on At Least and set it to 3 months old. On the Destination tab, populate the destination location with the path where you want to store the archived logs. There are additional options for compressing with password encryption, as well as sending notifications upon task completion. Now, let's create a second schedule to delete old files. Select Cleanup from the Task Type menu. On the Schedule tab, move the slider to Day. On the Source tab, populate the source location with the same path that was used as the destination location in the previous archive schedule that we created. Under File Age, select At Least and set to 1 year old. Finally, on the Cleanup Notifications tab, check Send Notification Report by Email and populate the recipient field. There are also options for removing empty folders. Simplify syslog management with Kiwi Syslog Server. For more information on Kiwi products, contact Kiwi Sales at solarwinds.com.